All right, so x plus 6 equals 15. How are we going to get x by itself?
Minus.
Just let that 6. Minus 6 on both sides. And kind of review. Kind of old news, hopefully, right?
Yeah.
To subtract 6 from both sides to solve for x. How about this one? X minus 8 equals negative 5.
All right.
Get x alone and get 3. X is 3. Okay, so we've solved equations using, in one case, subtraction, in one case, addition. All right, so if I change it, this is look familiar to what we just did?
Yeah.
The only difference being what? Right, it's not equations, it's inequalities, right? That's why they're called inequalities, because they're not equal. So what I'm trying to show you here is that the approach for solving inequalities is almost, in every case, exactly the same as solving an equation. Okay? In this case, I want some number plus x to be exactly equal to 15. For that to happen, x has to be exactly 9. No other number will work. 9 plus 6 is the only way to get 15 on this side, so that 15 equals 15. 3 is the only number that works in this equation. 3 minus 8 is negative 5. Only x that works. But here, we want the sum of x and 6 to be less than 15.
Right?
Not exactly 15, just less than 15. So I bet there's a lot of different x values that would work. Lots, in fact. How many would you say?
9.
More than that. More than that.
Infinity.
Any number that I plug in for x, where the result is less than 15, is a number that works. Okay? And it's no different to find it than when we solved an equation. Let's just subtract 6 from both sides. X just needs to be less than what?
15. No.
9. We found it before, x equals 9. Now x needs to be less than 9. If x is less than 9, then we've got it. Then this inequality is true. Let's test it out. Let's say that x is 9. 9 plus 6 is less than 15. Is this true? What's 9 plus 6?
15.
Is this true, what this is saying?
No.
Why is it not true, Dylan?
They're equal.
They're not. 15 is not
greater than 15.
15 is not greater than 15. 15 is not less than 15. 15 is equal to 15. And that is not something that's allowed in this inequality. So 9's out, but what's a number that's less than 9, but just barely less than 9?
8.
Even more just barely. 8.5. Even more just barely than
8.9.
You get really, really close. Let's start with 8.9. Let's get really close. 8.9 plugged in for x plus 6. Let's see if this works. What's 8.9 plus 6?
14.9.
Is that less than 15?
Yeah.
About 8.99.
Still less.
8.99, right? It's still going to be less. So any number that's less than 9 is going to be a-okay, right? It's going to work in this inequality. Right? So why don't you work out this second one over here real quick? All right, we should have had plenty of time by now to solve this inequality, to figure out what kind of numbers x can be. What can x be? Needs to be less than 3.
Wait. No.
Yeah.
No.
No.
Let's see how that works.
Negative 8 plus positive 2 equals 7 must be still greater than 5. So 2.99.
Well, let's see. Let's try a number that's. We hear less talking over there. Why? Let's try a number that's less than 3.
Negative 3.
Number that's less than 3. Let's try 2. 2 minus 8. See if this is. What's 2 minus 8?
Negative 6.
Is negative 6 greater than negative 5?
No.
No,
it's not. use a higher actual scale there.
Negative.
So it has to be.
Delaney and Mike, can you please stop talking?
It has to be bigger than 3.
Talking about.
What are you discovering?
So it has to be bigger than 3?
You saw your scale.
Okay. Did it work? Did plugging in 2 work?
No.
No.
So should x be less than 3?
Greater than 3.
What if x is greater than 3?
Then it would work.
Work. Let's try
4.
4 minus 8. Equal to -5. 4 minus 8 is?
4. -4.
-4. Is -4 greater than or equal to -5?
Yes.
It is. Remember that greater numbers are on the number line more to the right. And lesser than numbers that are smaller are more to the left. So -10 is actually smaller than -5 because it's more to the left. But -4 is greater than -5 because -4 is more to the right than -5. But what about just 3?
It'll be equal.
And is that okay?
Yes.
In case you're not aware, this little guy right here means this, that is okay. They can be equal, greater than or equal to. So we should say that x can be greater than or equal to 3. Right? We can solve, we can find that by adding 8 to both sides, just like we added 8 to both sides of this equation. Okay? Instead of being x being equal to 3, it can be greater than or equal. Any number that's greater than or equal to 3 is going to make this equation work just fine. If we did 3 minus 8, that would be -5, and that would work. If we had 4 minus 8 would be -4, and that would be greater than -5. 5 minus 8 would be -3. -3 would be bigger than -5. So on. Okay. Real quick, in this case, what can x be? Just like as a class, what could x be in this case?
What are all below.
Below, less than?
Anything?
Below 8.
Less than 8?
Yeah.
If we subtract 4 from both sides of the inequality, we'll find that x needs to be less than 8 in order for this side to be less than 12. Gonna make sense, right? We want x to, if we want this side with x on it to be less than something, then we're gonna want x to be some number or smaller, because we want to keep it to a small number. We want x to be small so that this side with x on it will be small. You know, if x is less than 8, then this guy will be less than 12. How about here? What can x be in this case? -2. Or is it like an example of something that would work?
Oh.
If we add 9 to both sides, just like we would if this said x minus 9 equals -3, we'd add 9 to both sides to solve for x. If we add 9 to both sides, we get x is less than or equal to, -3 plus 9 is 6. As long as x is less than or equal to 6, this side would be less than or equal to -3. 6 minus 9, will that work? I plug a 6 in for x?
It'll be equal.
It'll be equal, and since we have this little guy right here, that's fine. Right, it needs to be less than that, so if we do 5 minus 9, that'll be negative
4.
Will that be less than or equal to -3?
Yeah.
5 minus 9 is -4. Yeah, because it is farther to the left,
yeah.
It is less than. So if we want to solve an inequality, there's going to be a little bit of a catch to this in a few slides from now, but it's pretty much exactly the same as solving an equation. If we have x plus 4, let's subtract 4 from both sides. X minus 9, let's add 9 to both sides. Alright. Now we're switching, we're going to go back to equations again. We're going to solve the equation just a little bit different. You would do something slightly different to get x by itself. Let's see if we all can do that. six times x equals 24, so 2 get x by itself. Do what?
Mm-hmm.
5 by 6 on both sides, 5 by 6, 6 is 4. Are you sure that's right? X is 4?
Yes.
How do we check?
6 times 4.
6, put 4 back in the equation. 6 times 4 equals 24, yes, 24. And over here now, what do we do? Solve for x. 5 by 5, divided by negative 5. Negative 5 divided by negative 5, just like anything divided by itself is 1. 1x divided by negative 5 on this side, and x is negative 13 fifths.
Negative
2.6.
Is that
already?
It's the same thing.
Just 13 divided by 5 is 6. So yeah, that's the same thing. The only thing that I say about decimals is if you're going to write a decimal, fractions are fine. If you're going to write a decimal, then it better be exactly right. Like, not rounded, okay? So, it's kind of a sidebar here. If I had 1/3 and I said that's 0.3, that would be wrong.
You'd have to be 0.3
repeating. Repeating, right? Even 0.33, if you sat there from the beginning of the day to the end just writing threes, it would still be wrong, because you would still be rounding at some point, right? But if you wrote it this way, okay, then that would be correct. That would be 3... for all eternity. 3 repeated forever. So if you're not sure, leave me a fraction.
Fraction is fine.
Alright, so now we're going to take these equations, we're going to look at inequalities that look almost exactly the same, and then we're going to see the catch I was talking about. There's just a little bit of a twist when we're dividing. Okay. We'll see where that twist happens once we get to solving these. Let's solve both of these. So this is going to look so similar to what we just did, right? 6x is greater than or equal to 24. If we divide by 6 on both sides, x is greater than or equal to 4. Does that work?
Yes.
How can we be sure?
Yes.
How can we be sure?
6 times 4.
Mm-hmm. Try. 6 times 4
equals 24.
And is this true? Well, 24, is it greater than or equal to 24? It's equal to 24. Let's try another number that also fits this. X is greater than or equal to 4, like 5. Right? Let's try 5. So 6 times 5 is greater than or equal to 24. And ask ourselves if this is true. 6 times 5?
30.
30. Is this statement true?
Yes.
Yeah.
30 is greater than 24. So it looks like if I keep picking numbers for X that are bigger than 4, it'll just keep getting bigger and be even bigger and bigger and bigger than 24. All right. So here we divide by. Negative 5? Divided by negative 5. Okay, so negative 5 divided by negative 5 is 1, so we get 1x, just x. Okay, 15 divided by negative 5?
Negative 3.
So x is?
4.
This way? No, this way.
Yeah.
Okay, x is like 2, that's what it was there. Okay, so let's try it out. Let's try negative 3, right, because it says equal to is okay. Negative 5 times negative 3, is that less than or equal to 15? Let's see, negative 5 times negative 3, what's that? Negative times negative is positive, so you get 15 is less than or equal to 15, that's true. Now, just giving you a heads up, here's where the weird thing is going to happen. And we're going to realize that when we divide by negatives, the there's something more to think about, something more to do. So let's try plugging in something that's less than negative 3. What's the number that's less than negative 3?
Negative 4.
4 is less than negative 3, right? Because it's more to the left. So let's try negative 4. Negative 5 times negative 4, less than or equal to 15. Let's see if that's true. Negative 5 times negative 4?
20.
20. Is 20 less than or equal to 15?
No.
No, it's greater than. Okay. Let's think about why that happened. Because what do you get when you multiply a negative by a negative?
Positive.
Positive, right? So if I let x be less than negative 3, those the kinds of values for x I'm going to get are really, really negative. And I would think of really, really negative, and by really negative, I mean like negative 1,000, negative 1,000. That's really negative, okay? Well, I plug that really negative number in here, negative times negative is positive, so actually what happens is I get this really big positive number, which is not what I want. I want it to be less than 15. I actually want to get smaller and smaller numbers, right? So, because I'm multiplying by a negative on this side here, because there's this negative right there, I actually want to pick numbers that are bigger than. I don't want to go the other way with my x's, because there's this negative multiplied by the x. Okay. So, if I were to make the long story short, here's the long story short. When you divide both sides by a negative, take that inequality sign, flip it around. That's my universal symbol for flip it around. Okay. So we take it from a less than to a greater than. Because that negative kind of flips things around, makes things go backwards of what we thought they would do. So now if I pick numbers that are bigger than negative 3, let's change this to like a negative 2. A negative 5 times negative 2 is positive 10, and 10 is less than 5. So again, when we divide, or even if we multiply both sides by a negative, we're going to want to flip that sign around, flip that inequality sign around. Here's a couple more to practice. Let's solve both of these as well. All right, so we have 8x is greater than or equal to 22. We need x by itself by doing what?
Divide
by 8,
right?
X is greater than or equal to 22 over 8. We can simplify that to 11 over 4. Good. Division if you want to. And get
3 and 3 plus 3.75.
2.75. Yes, yes. Just shy of 3. 2.75. So as long as x stays bigger than that number, then 8 times x will stay bigger than 22. That makes sense. The numbers that are bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, so this side will stay larger than 22. All right, how about negative 4x equals 34? How are we going to solve that guy? By what? By negative 4, and we're dividing by a negative now. So when I write x, I'm going to write x is
greater
than or equal to, we're going to flip this guy around. And get x is greater than or equal to 34 over 4, x is greater than or equal to 32 over 17. You multiply or divide both sides by a negative, we're going to flip that around. In order for this to stay less than 34, we're going to want to let this go into the negative, which means this needs to be a positive number, which means that x needs to be bigger than something. X needs to be able to go into the positives. So this can be negative. Greater than or equal to a negative 17. So you divide 34 by negative 4. So, actually, let's do one more little thing where, let's say we take 3/4 x is greater than or equal to 27. Do you remember how to solve an equation when we have 3/4 times x? Anybody just want to throw it out there? How are we going to get x by itself?
Don't you?
Divide 0.75 by 27.
You can divide by 3/4. Divide by 3/4. Because whenever there's a number times x, we can divide by that number. It absolutely works. Also, if I'm dividing by a fraction, that's the same as multiplying by. If I divide 27 by 3/4, it's the same as multiplying 27 by what? 4/3, the reciprocal of 3/4, exactly. 27 divided by 3 is 9, and 9 times 4 is 36. So x needs to be greater than or equal to 36. So just remember that with fractions. If we had a negative 4/5, x is less than or equal to 16. How would we solve? Let's see, wait, how would we get x by itself here? Like multiply this by 5 over 1?
Yeah.
Well, then if we multiply by 5 over 4, then we'll take care of both of these at once. So we can cross cancel both of those. And we'll make it negative. So the negative times negative is positive. So what happens here is essentially we get negative times negative is positive. 20 over 4 times 5 is 20. And what's 20 over 20? 1, so we have 1x, which is x. 1 times x is x. So on the other side, we'll do the same thing. We'll multiply by negative 5/4. 16 divided by 4, that's going to be 4. 4 times negative 5, negative 20. 20, negative 20. What do I multiply by what? Negative 5. What's that?
80. Yeah.
That's good. I think the old-fashioned way. The old-fashioned way of what? Divided by negative 4/5? Divided by negative 0.8?
No, that would be, okay, that's why it didn't come out right.
Okay. We multiply by a negative, and whenever you multiply or divide on both sides by a negative, I want to flip that sign around. So x needs to be greater than or equal to negative. So whenever you multiply or divide by negative on both sides, and that's part of solving the inequality. Flip the sign. Flip the inequality sign. Alright, so we've added and subtracted both sides to get x by itself. We multiplied and divided on both sides to get x by itself. So now we'll put it all together. Okay. So we just takes right on through, walk us through solving this first equation. Anybody see anything that might change there?
No, that's exactly the way out.
How long would you have plus 3? Don't you have to subtract 3?
Oh,
yeah,
sorry.
So what's 3 plus 3?
6.
6. I mean, we can kind of keep going with it.
I meant to do the opposite. Right.
But what we really want to do is, So instead, I'm just going to take some of this stuff out, take that out. We're going to get something different there. We're going to have nothing left there. And that's going to be So, minus 3 instead, that leaves us with a 0 there. 17 minus 3 is 14 divided by 2 is 7. Okay, so we fixed it. All right, John?
Where'd you get
14? 17 minus 3.
I just said it on the sign.
All right, ready?
Ready.
All right, so. If you see that little positive there, that might get confusing. I know what you're saying in your notes is I'm going to add 5 to both sides. But it might look to someone else that you change the negative into a positive. And that would be all right, but we add 5 to both sides. Negative 5 plus 5 is 0. So we just have 3x on the left side, 18 on the right side, 13 plus 5 is 18. Divided by 3, x is 6. And it's they're different when we're solving inequality. Minus 3. Minus 3. In order for 2x plus 3 to be less than 17, 2x has to be less than 14. Right? This can't be any bigger than 14 because, well, then it wouldn't be altogether less than 17. Dividing by 2, we find that x then needs to be less than 7. So as long as x is less than 7, then this will be less than 17. What's the biggest that x could be?
6.9
repeating. 6.9 repeating. We got it. We nailed it down. That's as big as it can get. 6.9 repeating as many nines as you could physically write down. There's really, technically, no end to how big it can be, right? Because for as many nines as you can write down, 6.9 trillion nines, if I come along and put one more nine, I'm just a little bit bigger. Okay. So there's no biggest x. But we get the idea. We can get as close to 7 as possible without actually getting there. Which brings up the idea, like, how can we show what x is? We can show it with a graph. Okay? This graph only needs one dimension, only needs one variable, one axis. It doesn't need x and y, it only has an x. How can I show you on this number line that x is less than 7? First, we'll start out by showing 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
7. And you do a dot over 6.
Dot over 6.
And you do an arrow that way to the left.
Kind of fill all the
same. Yeah. Or, yeah, and that equals
X. No.
I don't know.
What about 6.5?
No.
Or from the 9, whatever, just don't touch the 7.
Okay, so get up to the 7, but don't touch the 7. The symbol that means that is a dot that
is
not filled in, right? It means go all the way to 7, but don't touch the 7. All the 6 point however many nines you want, but don't get to 7. I'm wrong?
Okay. That's not what I would have been. If it's open, that's like this side, and it's cold, like filled in. That's one of the ones up on.
Find somebody to tell you that, and I'll tell that person they're wrong. I think you remember. You ask Parsons.
I will. Can we go right now?
We're going to be done in a minute.
No,
you go over to Parsons and you ask him.
They're actually doing a test.
Oh.
They're taking a test over there, so.
Okay. You right.
Could probably do it at like 5
minutes.
Yeah,
that's a little
bigger.
Right.
Yeah,
that's
probably
going to
be
the
end class.
All right. Same thing here. We're going to add 5 to both sides. 3x is greater than 18. Dividing by 3 on both sides, we find that x needs to be greater than 6. So as long as x stays above 6, okay, then this number will stay above 18, and 18 minus 5 will stay somewhere above 13. And if I want to show you on a graph, then that's what x can be. First, I need to show you 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there's 6. X can be bigger than that, so it could be anything over here. But can it be equal to 6?
So we need to use an open circle. Quick assessment, it's sticking with you. Let's solve this equation. So we want to do what first?
Subtract.
Negative 3x is greater than or equal to 24. Divide by negative 3. So our final answer is x. Very good.
-8.
And why did it switch from greater than or equal to less than or equal to?
Oh, there's
I said it wrong.
Because what?
Because it's a negative.
Yeah, what's a negative?
8.
No, not because the answer is negative. Dividing by a negative on both sides to solve. Right? So we divided by a negative, which means we're going to switch that sign around to be less than instead of greater than. Less than or equal to instead of greater than. All right. And say that gives you just a bit. We have 6.1, 2, and 3 some selected questions. These would be where we add and subtract both sides to solve. This would be where we multiply and divide both sides to solve. And this would be where we have two or more steps to solve those inequalities.
All of them. Oh my god.
Finally!